India, with its large population, has key issue of solid waste management, with lot of waste seen in cities in large dumps. And also among the construction boom that we are seeing, there's the issue of construction and demolition waste. Among this, in the smaller sectors, in smaller sites, the waste is often dumped along roadsides and is not segregated. It reaches large open dumps and is often not sent to a recycling factory. We see this issue of C&D from the lens of asbestos cement roofing and how it is dumped across large spaces in India. We see how this toxic waste containing asbestos fibers is disposed of in farmlands and in areas where it can cause harm to human health. Asbestos cement roofing is the issue that we look today in our video. We talk to experts.
The asbestos roofing sheets, wherever I've seen it in Malba walks, they're usually just a part of what is illegally dumped.
Yes, I was actually surprised at how many asbestos fibers and bundles I was able to easily see.
Today, we look at the issue of India's toxic waste, asbestos cement roofing. We talk to Shamita Chaudhary, who's the founder of the Malba Project.
I'm Shamita Chaudhary. I am an architect. I have a master's in circular economy, and I'm the founder of Malba Project. Malba is the Hindi word for construction and demolition waste. So Malba Project has been operational in Delhi for about 3 years. We've conducted several pilot projects in collaboration with the Municipal Corporation of Delhi.
She also tells us about the formal process of construction and demolition waste in India.
As for the C&D waste management rules, the construction and demolition waste has to be, depending on whether you're a small waste generator or a bulk waste generator, has to be collected and transported to the authorized facility. If you're a small waste generator, the authorized facility is a collection point, a municipal corporation's designated collection point that might be the closest to you. From there, it will get collected and picked up by the recycling plant. The recycling plant will wash it, clean out the waste, segregate the parts that cannot be recycled by their plant.
She also tells us about the status of toxic waste disposal among the C&D waste.
Toxic waste that comes out of construction sites, in the everyday scenario, in the small waste generator scenario, say private construction projects, does not have a proper outlet.
She then tells us about the asbestos cement roofing, which they have spotted multiple times in waste deposits in cities.
I studied in Europe, where I closely also worked with how, or closely saw how they deal with this material over there. And the moment you have any iota of asbestos or any such carcinogenic material, so much care is taken while dismantling it. Every time we would go for a Malba walk, we would see asbestos cement sheets. We would see those roofing sheets still, you know, just around. Every time a demolition of an old house is happening, we would see that, oh, there's an asbestos sheet here and it is being taken off. But is there any special precaution being taken, to carefully handle that material while dismantling it? Nothing so far, because demolition is an activity that's highly unregulated, especially in the private sector, in the small residential construction sector. It is quite hugely problematic.
We also reach an open asbestos cement dump site and send the samples to a US lab, which seizes under the light microscope.
Yes, I was actually surprised at how many asbestos fibers and bundles I was able to easily see by light microscopy. In fact, I had warned you before I did the analysis that it's quite possible that it would be too small to see, or there wouldn't be enough asbestos fibers to get a good identification with a simple light microscope. And then I kind of ate my words. I put it in the refractive index liquid. I put it in under the polarized light microscope, and yes, it's confirmed. It is chrysotile. It was chrysotile white asbestos, which is consistent with what they were putting in by the pound, by the bag full, in order to manufacture these cement asbestos sheets. So it's not really surprising in retrospect.
As the results turned positive, Sean Fitzgerald, who is a geologist and asbestos testing expert, tells us the effects of it being in soil.
We've done many studies of various materials that contain much less than 1% asbestos. Specifically, the EPA did a study in Libby, Montana, where they were looking at vermiculite that was shown to contain much less than a percent, even less than a tenth of a percent, a hundredth of a percent. We're talking about a thousandth of a percent of actual asbestos content by weight was shown to release significant amounts of asbestos when that material was disturbed.
It's clear that asbestos fibers from asbestos cement roofing, which have been disposed, can become aerosolized and cause serious issues like lung cancer and mesothelioma. So we wonder, how does India deal with such a waste?